We join my father and son team, linguist David and actor Ben Crystal. You've got a book out all about accents. How on earth did that come about?
Well, good question. I've been acting and writing about Shakespeare for the last few years, got approached by these guys to write a book about accents, and I said, that's great, but you obviously want my father, not me.
Yeah, because you don't know the first thing about accents.
Well, yeah, I'd use them a lot, of course, but not, you know, that's his field. But then I suggested that we write the thing together.
Did you teach him how to do accents for his acting, or did you learn them in?
Oh, since he was a little baby about that big, yeah. We've been working on accents all this time.
Well, we'd always josh about, you know, like Monty Python and, you know, you were lucky and that kind of thing. And I remember that's one of the first times we
started. You always play with this sort of thing at home, don't you?
Your accent sounds from Liverpool to me.
I'm a mix, like most people are these days, you know. I mean, I grew up in North Wales, and then I went to Liverpool for my secondary schooling, and then I came down south, and so you get another change of accent there. So I'm a bit of a mongrel, so is Ben.
Yeah, I mean, I grew up, I was born in Ascot, and then I grew up in North Wales, and then I went to university in Lancaster. So I got the short air in my voice, and I came down to London, so I got a bit of Cockney. I spent a lot of time travelling around the States, and I got a lot of friends, and so I got a bit of transatlantic tease and stuff, so... I think most people have a mongrel accent.
It's pretty good. I can barely do my own accent.
What happens first, then, with accents, with picking things up? Do you pick up words or sounds? I've got a friend who lives in the States who's from Liverpool, and he's still got the broadest Scouser accent in the world. Yeah. But they'll say things like, take the garbage out, and it'll just drop into America just on certain words.
Well, this is the distinction between accent and dialect, isn't it? You see, dialects are a matter of vocabulary and grammar, whereas accent is pronunciation. So... this book is only about the accent side of things, and the amazing thing is that there are so many, you know, everywhere you go, there's a slightly different accent.
Is there more in Britain than any other country?
Well, as far as English goes, yes, because of the history of the English language in this country, with the periods of immigration... When the Anglo-Saxons arrived, they spoke different accents, you know, they came from different parts of Europe, and then the Vikings arrived, and then the French arrived, and so on, and then the immigrants over the last 600 years have arrived. So, as a result, there are more accents per mile in England and Wales and Scotland and Ireland than in any other part of the English-speaking world.
And all the most subtleties within that, so, you know, we talked about kind of Liverpool and North Wales, within the confines of that, do you find that...
Street to street.
Really?
Yeah, no, an accent can change across, like, one side of a street to the other. In terms of picking them up, I suppose, you know, with my actors, I either teach them there's the IPA, the phonetic alphabet, so you can read how to do it, you can listen how to do it. I like the shape of my mouth, so when you say garbage just then, think about the way that I change the shape of my mouth when I'm saying some gar.
Is that what is happening in accents? Yeah. People are speaking in a different way than that.
Look at this map. You've got some of the main places on here, like Birmingham and London and Dublin and so on, and they're the ones everybody notices. But in between all these areas, you know, there isn't such a thing as a Birmingham accent. There's a whole host of accents in the Midlands. One of the things we're trying to do at the moment, actually, is get a record of all these subtle things. You know, we're asking everybody in the world to...
Oh, no, this is brilliant. You can go on to yousaypotato.net and you can record, like, anybody can do this. You can record how, like, I'm Ben Crystal and I come from Holyhead in North Wales, and this is how I say potato. And we're getting people from all over the world, so it's going to be the largest collection in the world of people saying the single word.
How do you say potato?
I'm Tim Lovejoy from Royal Hertfordshire and I say potato.
I'm Simon Rimmer from Merseys and I say potato.
I emailed the poet Simon Armitage the other day and said, Simon, could you do this for us? And he just went, I don't say potato. I say chips.
And then Benjamin Zephaniah did it as well. And he, of course, has more than one accent, like we all do, actually. We all change our accents. We've got that, apparently.
Have you got that? Yeah.
My name is Benjamin Zephaniah, and I'm from Birmingham. When I'm out and about, I say potato. But when I'm at home, I say potato.
Ah, he's got two accents.
Yeah, that's right.
The people in the northwest, I'm going to insult people here, but are they speaking more nasally?
Well, that's the wrong word to describe,
isn't
it?
It's sort of more up there than where. Is that right or wrong?
Well, there are all sorts of variations, aren't there? There's the vowel changes, the consonant changes, there's the melody changes, there's the speed at which you speak changes. You know, there are dozens of different variables when you produce a different accent, which is why there are so many.
But if you're doing Manchester, do Manchester. Can you do Manchester?
On the spot now.
Can you do Manchester on the spot or something?
It's hard, isn't it, not to slip into Scouse. But
yeah, that's good.
You know, yes.
We've got some of the Manchester people already on the website saying potato, and the interesting thing is there isn't a single Manchester accent. You see, there's a whole host of them around the city.
But the thing I heard you nearly slip into there, which is I struggle to do as well, is that we have an association with different accents, don't we? Like, yeah. We think that X accent sounds comfortable, or X accent sounds daft or whatever, or indeed, like, received pronunciation, the accent of Shakespeare, of Lawrence Olivier, is the accent of the elite.
You see, that's the other thing we do. We're not just looking at accents now, we're looking at accents over the history of English. So Ben spends a lot of time doing Shakespeare in original pronunciation.
Right, Shakespeare in original pronunciation. Do it for us.
Do a sonnet, Ben.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou'rt more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds to shake the darling buds of May, and summer's lace hath all too short a debt. Sometime too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often is his gold complexion dimmed, and every fair from fair sometime declines by chance, or nature's changing course untrimmed. But thy eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose possession of that fair thou owest, nor shall death brag thou wanderest in his shade when in eternal lines to time thou growest. So long as men can breathe, or eyes can say, so long lives this, and this gives life to thee.
Geordie.
Very West Country.
Yeah, Geordie.
It's a bit of everything, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because the accent that was used round about the year 1600 was the kind of original of so many modern accents.
So in you tend to hear the accent that you most associate with.
Because of mass media, in the future, will we all have one accent? No, we won't.
There is a certain levelling taking place at the moment, as everybody notices. You know, there's an accent, Estuary English, it's often called. It's spreading around the country a lot. But at the same time, new accents are arriving, especially from abroad, you know?
Right, because I spoke to you before the show. One of the things which annoys me a bit at the moment is rather than saying I knew and news, people say new and news.
Yeah.
So it's the news.
Well,
Where's that come from?
Well, that's come mainly from American English, of course, because people are hearing it all the time on radio and television and so on. But actually, if you go back to Shakespeare's time...
Shakespeare would have done that,
you see.
Is it correct then
to say new rather than new?
Well, it depends who you're talking to.
You can't ask him about correct, because he's a descriptive linguist rather than a prescriptive
one.
Like so he'll never say one is worse than the other.
Yeah, that's like looking at a garden and saying, you know, that flower is right and that flower is wrong. I see accents as like a linguistic garden of flowers, and they're all beautiful to me.
Scone or scone?
I'd like a scone.
And me, I'm a scone person.
Scone.
What are you? I have to think about it, though.
Yeah, scone. Yeah. Scone's the answer, isn't it?
From now on, everybody who comes in your kitchen, let's get them to say scone and let's see what happens.
They get sacked if they don't.